Since my first sway video, some things have changed. So this is a fully updated video on how to install and configure sway on Arch Linux in 2023, and then configuring Waybar and Wofi to get this desktop you see on the screen. We will start from a bare bones installation where we have created a regular user with sudo access. And first we need to install some packages. So we run sudo pacman-S sway swaybg foot and polkit. We type our password and accept all the defaults. I'm gonna clear the terminal, and now we can simply run sway with the sway command. Now that we are inside, we can launch a terminal using the modifier key and enter. And by default, the modifier key is the Windows key. So let's press Windows and enter, and we have a terminal. I will increase the font size using Ctrl and plus so that you can see. And now let's create the directory that is necessary to store the sway configuration file. So we make dir -p .config/sway. And I will copy the default sway configuration into the directory that we have just created. So copy from etc sway / config into .config / sway config. Now I will open this file and modify it. So for that I will use NeoVim, but you can use any other editor. If you don't know how to use Vim or don't like it, you can use Nano, which is an easier to use editor. The first thing I will do here is modify this line, which sets the modifier key. By default, it's set to the Windows key, but I want to set it to Alt. So I simply change mod 4 for mod 1. Save the file. And now we need to reload sway using mod shift C. But mod is still set to the Windows key because we haven't applied these changes yet. So you still need to press Windows shift C. Sway has reloaded, and now Alt is your modifier key. Now I'll just quit this editor and show you some simple sway commands. So to close the currently active window, you press mod, shift, and Q. To launch a terminal, you press mod and enter. To move to a different workspace, you press mod and the number key. So mod 1 is for workspace number 1, mod 2 takes us to this workspace, and so on. And to move a window from one workspace to another, you press mod, shift, and the number. So for example, if we want to move this terminal, which is currently active, to the workspace number 2, we press mod, shift, 2. And now that terminal is in the workspace 2, and now we can move to that same workspace with mod 2. And we are here. I will open the same file again, but this time I will modify the font. But before doing that, I first need to install the font that I want to apply. So the font I want is Adobe Source Code Pro-Fonts. So we install this. And now I can open the file. So again, I'm gonna open it with NeoVim, sway config, and here at any point in this file, you can simply set the font with this command, font pango colon space, the name of the font. In my case, it's Source Code Pro, medium and 12. And pay attention to the capitalization here, and I'll make it a little bit bigger so that you can see it well. I'm gonna save the file and now reload sway with mod shift C. And now the text in the top bar is a little bit bigger, but this doesn't change the default font for the terminal. So let's quit this terminal. I'm gonna launch another terminal. And as you can see, the text in the terminal is still small. and that's because the terminal has its own configuration file. So now I will configure the terminal, and for that I first need to create a directory called .config/foot, because foot is the terminal that we have installed and that we are using. And then I will copy the default foot configuration from /etc/xdg/foot/foot.ini. And I will copy that one into .config/foot. Now I open this file, .config/foot/foot.ini, and I scroll down to this this line, font monospace size 8. I'm gonna change this one to, instead of monospace, source space code space pro, and size I'll set it to 24. Save the file, and now we don't need to reload Sway, we only need to launch another terminal. So I will close this terminal and open it with mod enter, and as you can see that the terminal now starts from a big font, and it's a different font actually, it's not the same that we had before. Now what happens if we want to launch a program that is not a terminal? We could launch it from here, for example. Actually, I don't have Firefox installed, so I will install it. But okay, one way to launch Firefox is from here, but this is not very, doesn't look very good, and we need to keep this terminal open. I mean, there are some tricks we could use to get rid of this terminal and keep launching Firefox, but it's still uncomfortable to have to launch a terminal before launching Firefox. So what we use is we install what is called a launcher, an application launcher. And the one I use is called Wofi. So I'm gonna install it with sudo pacman-S Wofi. Accept this. And now to use it, we need to modify the sway configuration file. So I'm gonna modify the file in .config/sway config, the same file we've been modifying the whole time. And here we scroll down to this line, the set menu the menu path line, and we simply change the line from here, we delete this to the end of the line, and we are going to replace that with Wofi space --show/run. We save the file and we reload Sway using mod shift C. And now if I press mod D, this menu appears here, and this menu will allow me to run any file, that's executable file that is on my path. So for example, if I launch Firefox, it launches directly without the need of a terminal. So I can just close this terminal here and this one, and Firefox got run from, executed from Wofi, not from a terminal. In fact, I can launch it here, Firefox, or I could launch any other application that's on my path. And on my next video, I will show you how to customize Wofi so that it looks a little better than this. But for now, I think this is enough. So next thing I will do is I'm going to install Waybar, which is a bar that will replace this bar on the top of the screen. So for that, I open a terminal and I simply install it using pacman. And now to activate Waybar, I need to edit the sway configuration file again. So we modify the same file again. And in this file, we need to go to the end of the file. And this is the section that defines the top bar. So we delete all these lines between the two braces, and all we have to put inside of these braces is we tabulate, we indent this line, and type swaybar underscore command space waybar, and we save the file and reload sway. And you can see that the top bar is changed, but it doesn't look very good, because it relies on a specific font, that includes some icons. So to install that font, we just need to type sudo pacman dash capital S ttf dash font dash awesome. Install that, and now we can reload Sway, and now we can see the icons in the top bar, in the Waybar. Now I am going to customize Waybar, and for that we first need to create a directory in .config slash Waybar. And one thing we could do is copying the default configuration files from etc/xdg slash Waybar, and I'm going to use the asterisk because they are two files, and copy those into our directory that we just created. And then we could modify these files if we wanted. But I am not going to do that because I already have my Waybar customization, and it's in a GitHub repo. And in fact, I have an entire video where I teach you how to create your own Waybar customization. So if you want to know how to do that, you can go to this video, which is on my channel. But for now, I am just going to copy those files. And to copy those files or to download those files, I'm going to use Git. So install Git if you haven't installed it yet. And I also am going to need to install a font package, which is called ttf-roboto-mono. So install that, because my configuration file uses this font, so you should install it if you are going to use my configuration file, of course. And we clone my configuration file using this command, git clone https://github.com/sandop/sway-configs-2023. Press enter, and now they are cloned. And now what we need to do is copy everything that is in sway-configs-2023 waybar slash asterisk, and we copy all of both of those files into .config slash waybar. Okay, and now we reload Sway with mod shift C, and this is my configuration file. And again, if you want to see how I created this file, this configuration, you can go to this video that I have on my channel. And on my next video, I'm going to show you how to make it so that Wofi has the same style as Waybar. I'm going to manually modify the Wofi configuration so that it looks congruent with our top bar, which in this case looks like this. Now, another thing I want to teach you how to do is to have gaps between the windows. So for that, all you need to do is open the Sway configuration file again. And here, anywhere, you can just type gaps space inner space and a number of pixels. In this case, let's say 4px, and gaps outer 4px also. And we save the file and reload Sway. And now we have gaps between our windows. In this case, it's a small gap, but you can increase this number, let's say 20px, so that you can see it. Save the file, and we move to another workspace to see it in action, because this workspace was created when there were no gaps. So reload Sway, move to another workspace, and open Windows here. And then you will see the gaps. And the final thing that I'm going to show you how to do is to disable the mouse acceleration and swap the keyboard escape key and the caps lock key. And to do that, we go back to our Sway configuration file. And I'm going to scroll down just for organization purposes, because you could type this anywhere, but I'm going to put it here where it says input configuration. I'm going to type input space quotes type colon keyboard quotes XK, xkb underscore options caps swap escape. And this is going to swap between swap between the escape key and the caps lock key. So I reload sway and the changes take effect. And how to disable mouse acceleration? It's similar. You just type type input type pointer, and here axel underscore profile space flat. Okay, we save this file, reload sway, and now if you move your mouse, you're going to notice that there's no acceleration anymore. So I'm gonna close this file. And that's all I wanted to show you today. And in my next video, remember that I'll show you how to customize Wofi to make it look better. And I'm going to modify the default configuration and manually make it look similar to this configuration. But you will be able to make it look however you want with any colors, because the configuration is not that hard to modify. So that's everything for today. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please leave a comment below, leave a like, and subscribe. Goodbye.